Michelle Poehler. She lived her whole life in fear of everything until one day she said, no more.
Michelle Poehler decided that she was sick of living her life in fear of the unknown.
I'm here with Michelle Poehler in Times Square, New York City, where she is living 100 days without fear.
Michelle Poehler found the benefit over and over again of facing her fears, and she's helping others benefit as well.
By overcoming her fear of live TV right now, Michelle Poehler is with me.
Welcome to you, Michelle Poehler. Thank you for being here.
So, my pleasure.
The lovely Michelle Poehler.
Please join me in welcoming Michelle Poehler.
So the things that are uncomfortable to me may be things that you can easily do. Eating an oyster. And when I realized that fear was the one thing that could keep me from achieving my dreams, I embarked on a project that changed my life for good. It is called the 100 Day Project. So I decided to face 100 fears in a period of 100 days, from the smallest things that were limiting my everyday life to fears I never thought I would be able to conquer. I got to experience what living life to the fullest feels like. And what I learned is that it only happens when we do the things we love like no one's watching.
I freaking love her. She has this energy about her.
Her energy on stage, the dancing, the videos.
She was very energetic and entertaining.
And she blew me away.
I learned the important difference between fearless and brave. Brave is when, despite the fear, we have the courage to take action. And that is way more powerful and inspiring than being fearless. True leaders are not those who hide their fears or pretend to be fearless. True leaders are those who take action despite their fears, are those who lead by example, mostly when it's hard.
I feel super inspired by Michelle Poehler.
Thousands of people here, everybody loved her.
She's very engaging. She really talks to your heart.
Belonging can be amazing. It's what enables community, friendship, team building. But if we're not careful, our need to fit in may hurt our authenticity. And we live in a time where authenticity is one of the most valuable assets that anyone could have.
She's really authentic, and I think it's a fresh message.
Michelle was very inspiring and absolutely hilarious.
Raise your hand if you thought that was just a little bit uncomfortable, and you're like, please, someone dance with her.
Courage is contagious. How am I supposed to gather the courage that I need if I'm only considering the worst case scenarios? And I ask myself, Michelle, what's the best that can happen, right?
She is full of life. That's who she is. You can see that the moment she comes out and smiles.
She's herself, and that attracts a crowd.
She made everyone else get up and dance at the end, and you know, everyone was just loving it. It was great.
What I learned is that the enemy of success is not failure. It's actually comfort.
Comfort is what keeps us from going after new prospects, right? Comfort convinces us to stay with partners we no longer love and in places or cities we cannot get much out of. Comfort begs us to look down at our phones instead of sparking a conversation with the person sitting right next to us. And it tells us things like, good things come to those who wait.
The more uncomfortable we get, the greater the reward.
It was only when I got really uncomfortable and decided to commit to this project full time that I started to see real impact. Something that started as a school project turned into my purpose, a social mission that is encouraging people all over the world to say hello to their fears.
It's just exactly what everybody needs to hear. Everybody has a fear of some kind, and to see how she faced those and that any of us could do that and what she's turned it into is just so inspiring.
It just does something to you because it literally makes you want to leave here and get to work.
I would love to be like her when I grow up.
Am I afraid of failing? You bet I am. But I am 100% more terrified of not even trying at all.
Now, instead of perceiving every fear as an obstacle, I choose to see it as an opportunity that can lead us to uncover our next big thing.
And that is the best that could happen.
What would you get uncomfortable for? What are those things you care so much about that you're willing to get uncomfortable to make them happen?
Fantastic. Thank you, Michelle, so much for your tremendous insights and for challenging us to tackle our fears so we can all achieve great things. I think we can all agree this was the perfect, uplifting, and inspiring message to conclude our preview program.
You ready? Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Michelle Paul.